សូមអញ្ជើញគាត់ចុះអង្គជំនុំជម្រះប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសមាការកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសមាការកាលពីម្សិលមិញវេរសៀលមុននឹងបញ្ចប់នឹងគឺដល់វេទិកានៃការឆ្លើយតបរបស់សហប្រញ្ញាដែលមានរយៈពេល1ម៉ោងហើយសហប្រញ្ញាជាតិបានធ្វើរួចហើយនៅសហប្រញ្ញាអន្តរជាតិកន្លះម៉ោងប៉ុន្តែមុននឹងបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសមាការដោយការឆ្លើយតបរបស់សហប្រញ្ញាបន្តអង្គជំរះសំសួរទៅសហប្រញ្ញាអំពីពេលវេលាដែលអង្គជំរះបានមានបំណងក្នុងការសួរស្ដាប់ចម្លើយសក្ខីកម្មអសស័យចំនួន2រូបគឺ TCW 766ហើយនិង TCW 542នៅក្នុងសប្ដាក្រោយសំណួរសួរថាតើសហប្រញ្ញាត្រូវពេលការពេលវេលាប្រមាណសម្រាប់សួរសក្ខីម្នាក់ម្នាក
់ Thank you Mr. President and good morning Your Honor
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានសូមគោរពលោកស្រីចៅ
We anticipate in relation to TCW 766 Obviously, on the basis that the Chamber has indicated that Your Honours will lead the examination of this witness and the discussion will follow. We'll obviously try and complement your examination and not repeat any of the areas you've covered. So we anticipate about half a day should be sufficient for that purpose. And with respect to TCW 542, again here we'll try to be as efficient as we can. We believe not more than 3 sessions would be required, approximately 4 hours. There again, we'll try and be as quick as we can. It may well be possible to complete that examination in half a day, but if that level of flexibility could be accommodated, we'll certainly try and be as quick as we can. Also, Your Honours, while I'm on my feet, you indicated yesterday that it might be helpful if prosecution would provide a new version, an updated version of the evidence lists from the prosecution indicating which of the documents originate or were received from DCK. We believe that we're in a position to do this by Tuesday, which I think was the time requested by my learned friend. We'll attempt to, in fact, do that even earlier. But we believe that on Tuesday we can have all of those lists provided to the Chamber and the parties indicating, as I said, for each document, how many of them came from DCK.
តន្ទឹមនឹងបញ្ជីឯកសារដែលមានប្រភពចេញមកពីមជ្ឈមណ្ឌលឯកសារកម្ពុជា
បាទអរគុណសហប្រញ្ញាហើយជាបន្តខាងមេធាវីនៅមុខតំណាងដើមរឿងរដ្ឋប្រនីក្នុងការស្ដាប់ចម្លើយសាក់សីដូចពីររូបមិញនេះថាត្រូវការពេលវេលាប្រមាណដែរក្នុងការសួរទៅសាក់សីមួយរូបមួយរូប
សូមគោរពលោកប្រធានសូមគោរពលោកលោកស្រីចៅក្រមអស់លោកលោកស្រីដែលមានវត្តមានទីនេះមេធាវីនាំមុខសម្រាប់ការសួរយកចម្លើយទៅលើសាក់សីទាំងពីររូបនេះមេធាវីនាំមុខត្រូវការពេលវេលាសម្រាប់សាក់សីនីមួយៗរយៈពេល2ម៉ោងដូច្នេះមានន័យថាសម្រាប់សាក់សី542មានរយៈពេល2ម៉ោងនិងសាក់សី766មានរយៈពេល2ម៉ោងសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាន
បាទអរគុណចូលខាងមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកនួនជាយ៉ាងម៉េចដែរ
អ Thank you for the. I had a brief discussion with my colleagues on, for the defence. We envisaged that for the first witness, 766, if I'm correct, all defence teams together will need 1 or 1.5 days, and we can divide the time amongst each other. That's a very rough estimate, of course, because we are last in the queue and we don't know how many questions will have been asked and how many points will need further clarification. It's a very rough estimate. And for the other witness, I estimate half a day for my own cross-examination. Sorry, we haven't discussed that particular witness yet with the other teams.
បាទអរគុណចុះលោកមេធាវីការពារក្តីយើងសេរីចំពោះថាសាក់សី TC W 502ត្រូវការចំណាយទៅពេលវេលាប្រមាណដែរក្នុងការសាក់សួរសូមគោរពលោកសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានចំពោះសាក់សី TC W 502ត្រូវការពេលវេលាប្រហែលជា1ម៉ោងទៅមួយម៉ោងកន្លះដោយឡែកសម្រាប់TCW 761ហ្នឹងគឺសម្រាប់តាមអ្វីដែលក្រមមេធាវីការពារលោកនួនជាបានអះអាងមិញហើយថារវាងពី1ថ្ងៃទៅ1ថ្ងៃកន្លះសម្រាប់ក្រមមេធាវីទាំង3សូមអរគុណអរគុណចុះក្រមមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកខៀវសំផនលើ TCW 542.
សូមអរគុណ so, លោកប្រធាន សម្រាប់សាក់សី TCW 542 យើងត្រូវការពេលវេលាប្រហែលពី 15 នាទីទៅ 1 ម៉ោង ហើយសម្រាប់ សាក់សី TCW ដូច លោក Pacement PTCW 766 ដោយលោក Pacement បាន ជម្រាប ជូន ក្រុម ប្រឹក្សា ជំនួយ ព្រះ អម្បាញ់ វិញ គឺ ថា យើង នឹង ប្រើ ពេល វេលា ទៅ តាម ការ ស្នើ សុំ នោះ បាទ
បាទ អរគុណ នៅ ក្នុង ការ បង្ហាញ ចំហរ និង ការ ប៉ាន់ ស្មាន នៅ រយៈ ពេល នៃ ការ តាំង សំណួរ ចំពោះ សាក់សី ដែល យើង គ្រោង ធ្វើ នៅ ក្នុង សប្តាហ៍ ក្រោយ ការ ដែល ធ្វើ ដូច នេះ ដើម្បី ងាយ ស្រួល ក្នុង ការ រៀបចំការវិភាកនៃកិច្ចដំណើរការសហនការឲ្យបានឆាប់រហ័សនិងមានប្រសិទ្ធភាពជាកិច្ចបន្តអង្គជំរះសូមផ្ដល់វេទិកាទៅសហព្រះញ្ញាដើម្បីបន្តឡើងធ្វើការអំណះអំណាងតបទៅនឹងការចំទាស់របស់មេធាវីការពារក្តីទាំងបីក្រុមទៅលើឧបសម្ព័ន្ធឯកសារ A4
Thank you, Mr. President. Time is short, and our learned friends obviously made a number of objections to this document category yesterday. What I intend to do is deal as quickly as I can with some of the issues that were raised, perhaps the most important issues that were raised by the defence, and then in the remaining time show a few documents that in our submission from which you can see in our submission that reliability and relevance are established in all cases simply by looking at the documents and conducting basic due diligence in reviewing the case file. So turning first to the objections made by Nguyen Chia's team, I think the core set of objections I think related to the issue of relevance and whether or not all of these documents are relevant to the first trial in this case. It's always a little bit unfortunate, Your Honours, when we find that facts are misstated by our learned friends. There was an implication, I think, that the prosecutors were suggesting had filed this list in relation to the first trial, and that this was a list prepared following the severance order, which of course is not true. These lists were filed in April, to be more exact, on the 19th of April, and of course a second version of that of those same lists was filed in July, and that list indicated documents which we considered relevant to the first phase of the trial. It was only following the submission of those lists that Your Honours issued the severance order on the 22nd of September. And of course, in that severance order, Your Honours indicated that although this first trial will deal with the two specific sets of crimes that you have indicated, that additional crimes may be added. And furthermore, in your decision on our request for reconsideration of severance, and that is document E124/7, Your Honours indicated that in considering the addition of further crimes, in addition to those first two criminal episodes, that you would be guided by the OCP's recommendations. And you attached to that decision a list of relevant paragraphs for this first trial. And those paragraphs include all of the sections of the indictment dealing with the structures, the authority structures, communications mechanisms, the ministries of Democratic Kampuchea, the authority structures of the Communist Party of Kampuchea, and so forth. All of the parts of the indictment dealing with the establishment and operations of this regime are relevant. They are a part of this first trial, whether the defense like it or not. In no less than 142 paragraphs of the indictment, the investigating judges dealt with the operations and the structure of this regime. And of course, all of these documents go to proving the existence of an authority structure, the communications within that authority structure, and the ways in which the accused issued their orders and were able to ensure the implementation of the criminal plan, which is alleged in the closing order. Your Honours further indicated that, of course, the accused must confront all allegations contained in the indictment. And of course, you did that in the scheduling order for the opening statements, and that was document E131. There can be no suggestion that these documents, which relate to the operations and the structure of the regime and the communication systems, are somehow not relevant to this first trial. I'll try and deal very quickly with some of the examples that my learned friend gave. But before I do that, I'd like to also just make reference to the way in which the defense has approached its obligations in this respect. The Nguyen Chea team, in fact, has refused to submit any list of evidence, has indicated, in fact, that they will... I apologize to the interpreters. They have, in fact, indicated that they will file any documents which they consider relevant at any time that they consider appropriate. And they did so in their observations, document D109/3. And it was disappointing, I think, to hear our friends yesterday indicate that we are here at a risk of drowning in evidential material which has been classified, catalogued, summarized and provided, and which has been on the case file for 2 or 3 years and in many cases longer. The prosecution has done its due diligence, and we simply invite the defense to do the same. With respect to the specific examples that were cited, again, it was unfortunate that counsel, in referring to the specific examples, didn't read the entire entry that was being referred to. For example, there was reference to document number 165 in our list. This is in fact document introductory submission 21.16. Of course, this document, like the other telegrams, is proffered in many cases simply because it shows the existence of a regular, structured and hierarchical communication system which was in place throughout the period covered by the indictment. And if my friend had looked at the page that he was citing for entry 165, relevance is of course indicated in the very line which from which he was reading. And we indicate there that the relevance is the operation of officers of 870 and the communication structures. Furthermore, Your Honours, had our friend done a simple word search in the closing order, he would have found that this document is in fact referred in paragraph 77 of the closing order, which, as I indicated earlier, is of course a part of this of the sections of the indictment which are the subject of this first trial. We have limited time, so I'm unable to go through all of the examples. But again, a simple due diligence search indicates that each document its relevance. And ultimately, of course, as we've indicated, telegrams show the existence of a structured communication system through which the accused ensured the implementation of the common criminal plan. Another example, document 359 was cited. Again, Your Honours, the list clearly indicates the relevance of that document to be the communication structure and the Nguyen Chia's involvement in the common criminal plan. The document itself is cited again in the closing order at paragraph 876, which again is before Your Honours in this first trial. And lastly, I'll just refer to one more document, document 365 on our list. Again, relevance is indicated in the document from which my friend was reading. It relates to the operations of officers of 870 and again to the existence of structured channels of communication. And furthermore, a basic search of the case file would have indicated that this document was in fact an attachment to a witness statement. This witness was interviewed by the Office of the Co-Investigating Judges. This witness is TCW604, and the witness has been identified by Your Honours as a trial witness. So again, in relation to that document, there is more than enough indication both of its relevance and the way in which it can be further examined by the court and the other parties. In response to Ing Sari's team, again trying to be very brief, there was indication that it would be appropriate and certainly international practice indicates that in where telegram communications or radio intercepts are at issue, that it is appropriate to call either the authors of those communications or if the authors are not available, and in some cases people who are familiar with the systems can be called. Of course, that's exactly the approach Your Honours have taken in this case. There are several telegram operators who have been scheduled to testify. This is in fact the next group of witnesses who will be testifying. So my friend is correct in saying that it is appropriate to hear telegram operators. I'll just give a few examples. We have TCW695, TCW398, TCW480, TCW307, etc. All of these witnesses are either telegram operators or telegram decoders. They're former junior cadre or staff of various officers of Democratic Cambodia, both in Phnom Penh and in other parts of the country. With respect to the documents that were referred to by my friend, counsel for Mr. Ing Sari, there was a reference, a number of questions were asked as to who are the people mentioned in these documents. Of course, in many cases, the witnesses will provide such information. But even more immediately, that information is available in the closing order. It is available on a very basic search of the case file. In relation to 21.14, my friend asked who is Hang. Well, Your Honours, if you do a search of the closing order, the answer is there. Hang was, of course, Bu Phat, former secretary of Sector 103. He's referred in paragraphs 425 and 943 of the closing order. His confession from S21 is on the case file, and that document is D159/5.4. Not only that, Your Honours, the secretary who replaced this individual is himself a witness, has been called by Your Honours, and he is TCW428. Another example given by my friend was D366. Described a paragraph 1262 of the closing order. In fact, at paragraph 958 of the closing order, the investigating judges quotes Duch's statement, and I quote, Nguyen Chia also had Bosnim arrested, who was his brother-in-law and secretary of the Northwest Zone. Plenty of information about these individuals in the case file. I'll skip a couple of examples and just deal with one which perhaps may have appeared at face value to be unusual. My friend referred to D199/14.2. This was a postcard, a copy of a postcard. The question was asked as to perhaps why this is relevant. Of course, Your Honours, this again is an item which is referred to in the closing order. Not only is it referred to in the closing order, it's actually described in some detail. And if you look at paragraph 1094, the second part of that paragraph explains that this individual was in fact a diplomat in Senegal, a democratic Kampuchean cadre, who was recalled according to the indictment back to Cambodia, and of course found himself arrested and imprisoned at S21 within 4 days of arrival. The relevance of the postcard, of course, as the closing order explains, is that it was sent from Beijing en route back to Cambodia, where this gentleman was informing his family about his intended arrival in Phnom Penh. Tragically, of course, he was killed. Further information about that case is contained in a witness interview of that gentleman's wife, and that witness interview is D199/14. Your Honours, clearly, for any of these documents that were referred to by the defence, a simple due diligence exercise and a review of the case file provides both the indicia of reliability and clearly the indicia of relevance to the issues that we're dealing with. Turning now to some examples that weren't raised by my friends, but which in our submission demonstrate how these collections must be viewed as a whole and how these documents must be examined in light of other evidence, which supports both their relevance and reliability. I'll deal with as many documents as I can in the time that is remaining. Just by way of overview, the Annex 4DK communications, there are 393 documents which we identified as relevant to the first phase of the trial. I think Your Honour's memo might have indicated 394. There might be a difference there of one. We think the number might be 393. Out of these 393, a total of 168 documents were admitted by Your Honours in case one. So based obviously an exercise of review of relevance and reliability was undertaken in that case, and we would say certainly for the purposes of reliability that where an exhibit was admitted in case one, there is a strong assumption obviously that those documents are reliable, that they are what they purport to be, and of course the test being prima facie reliability. And as I've indicated before, relevance again is indicated for each of them. The communications, as my friend indicated yesterday, are comprised of five types of documents. They are DK telegrams, reports, letters, notes, and orders. With respect to each subcategory, there are a number of ways of ascertaining relevance and reliability. They include, of course, the testimonial evidence that is on the case file, witness statements from telegram operators, former cadre, including those whom I referred to earlier, and a few examples that I will show. And, of course, these documents, when you consider them, we would submit that you need to consider them as a whole, as a series of documents. And I will give just one example. I believe some 13 documents were authored by an individual called Leng. And in fact, he authored some of the documents with his alias Leng, and then some of them are authored with his name, with his alias Chan. Of course, Your Honour, this was the secretary of Independent Sector 105. The circumstances of his death and the his responsibilities for Sector 105 are described in the closing order, described in numerous witness statements, and as it turns out, two witnesses who have been called are his close family members. They are TCW695 and TCW307. And when you look at those 13 telegrams, you see obviously that they deal with a series of events. There's a certain internal consistency as to the events being described, and there is obviously reliability through testimonial evidence on the case file. And so documents must, Your Honours, be viewed, we submit, in groups and, of course, in relation to other evidence which indicates or corroborates their contents. I will not now try and demonstrate that by referring to a few examples in the time that we have remaining, and dealing first with the DK telegrams. Mr. President, if we could now show a document that is on our screen, or should be on our screen shortly. Thank you, Mr. President. This is an example of a telegram. In this case, it appears that we have the co-investigating judges have in fact obtained an original or a photograph of the original document. And of course, a senior staff member of DC Camp has indicated that this document is available in its original form. This is the Khmer version, of course. The statement of the DC Camp staff member is D311/2. If we scroll down to the bottom of this page, we've actually redacted, I believe, the name of the author of this telegram. That's because the author is in fact TCW604, a witness whom Your Honours have scheduled to appear before you. In his statement D201/5, he indicates that he wrote this document himself. Again, Your Honours, looking to the relevance of this document, the contents of the document are of some interest, but certainly insofar as they relate to the searching for, as they were called, Yuan spies. But more broadly, as I indicated earlier, the relevance, again, is the establishment of a regular and structured reporting system, which was in place throughout the period covered by the indictment. Mr. President, if I could move on to another document. And this is D175/6.13. If we can show that document on the screen, that's appropriate. Again, Your Honours, I'll only show the Khmer version, given that the time is limited. Again, in this case, this appears to be an original. At D311/2, a senior staff member of DC Camp indicates that an original is available. Another document authored by the same cadre, who happens to be the secretary of the Northeast Zone, was admitted by Your Honours in case one. So another document from the same series has already been admitted. That document is D175/6.15. And lastly, in relation to this document, it has in fact been authenticated by a witness, and that witness is TCW480, He is scheduled to testify shortly before Your Honours. In fact, not only does he discuss the telegram, he was able to discuss the handwriting on the telegram, which indicates that this document was to be, a copy of this document was to be given to Yang Sari. If I may move on to another example of a telegram. If we could show on the screen document introductory submission 21.146.
If that's appropriate.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is in fact, if we could have that document on the screen, please. Thank you. Again, I will show only a Khmer version given that we have limited time. This is a document from the Commerce Committee in Phnom Penh addressed to Comrades Kring and Nat. Comrade Nat was in fact Pal Va, as other evidence on the case file indicates. She was the wife of an individual called Ing Sok. Together, Ing Sok and his wife Pal Va were located in Hong Kong, where, as again evidence indicates, they were in charge of the Ren Fung Company, through which Democratic Cambodia conducted its international trade. And of course, a reference was made yesterday to the fact that these offices were very much under the authority of the accused Khieu Samphan. The contents of this document are interesting insofar as other documents then indicate what happened after this telegram was sent. This telegram was, directing Nat and her children to return to Phnom Penh. The husband, Ing Sok, was also to return. And, Your Honour, if we can again show two documents on the screen, we have a prisoner sheet, which is document IS 3.1, if we could have that on the screen, Your Honour. If we could show that document, this is introductory submission 3.1. This is the prisoner sheet of Ing Sok, alias, of Pal Va, alias Nat, and that indicates that she entered S21 on the 30th of December 1972. Only 20 days after that telegram was sent to Hong Kong. We will show another prisoner sheet, which is that of her husband. This is, introductory submission 3.1. I apologize, the wife's prisoner sheet was 3.5 and the husband's is 3.1. If we could return back to our screen just for a moment to show again how these documents come together, I'd like to show you some photographs which are in the case file, again as part of IS 3.5. If we could show that on the screen, Your Honour, I think we have about 2 minutes left. If we can, this is 3.5. There on the left-hand side, you see Pal Va alias Nat, a photograph taken in Hong Kong. And on the right-hand side, a photograph taken at S21. And last but not least, the circumstances of the arrests and of the return to Cambodia and the arrests of these individuals are discussed by Dutch in his written record before the co-investigating judges, document D119. Your Honours, I'd anticipated or had intended to deal with each of the subcategories, and we have numerous more examples like these, where telegrams, letters, orders, and notes, as well as reports, contain information that is corroborated by other documents. They contain information that is often discussed by witnesses. And of course, in as far as we're dealing with telegrams or letters reports specifically, several cadre explain the circumstances in which such documents were prepared. They describe the systems that were used, and they will of course describe for Your Honours specific markings that illustrate these are Democratic Cambodia and Communist Party of Cambodia documents and records. I think that brings me to a conclusion, given that I think I've run out of time. I'm happy to discuss any of the other categories if you understand that appropriate. But I'll stop here for now.
Thank you.
សម្រាប់ញ៉ារងអន្តរជាតិជាកិច្ចបន្តអង្គការប្រកួតនីតិដល់សមាជិកវិនិយោគរំលងដើមរឹងរដ្ឋនីដើម្បីមានឱកាសក្នុងការធ្វើអំណះអំណាងតបទៅនឹងការចំទាស់នឹងឯកសារក្នុងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធ A4 ដោយក្រុមមេធាវីការពារក្តីសូមជឿនសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានមេធាវីនាំមុខសូមប្រកល់សិទ្ធិនេះ
ជូន ដល់ លោក ឡាវ ជន្ធី ជា មេធាវី មក ពី ក្រុម មេធាវី ការពារ ផ្នែក ជំនួយ ផ្លូវ ច្បាប់ កម្ពុជា សូម លោក ប្រធាន អនុញ្ញាត
អនុញ្ញាត តាម ការ ស្នើ សុំ សូម ជឿញ លោក មេធាវី តំណាង ដើម រឹង រដ្ឋ រំនី ដែល ទទួល សិទ្ធិ
បាទ ជឿន ប្រធម ខ្ញុំ បាទ សូមគោរពអង្គជំនុំជម្រះទាំងមូលសូមគោរពសភាតាហើយសូមគោរពអ្នកដែលចូលរួមមើលនៅពេលនេះខ្ញុំបាទឡៅជន្ទីជាមេធាវីដើមដឹងរដ្ឋនីនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងសូនសូនពីនេះហើយឥឡូវនេះគឺខ្ញុំសូមធ្វើការឆ្លើយតបទៅលើប្រធានបទដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធទី4ដែល បានលើកឡើងនៅក្នុងវគ្គនេះដោយយោងទៅលើឯកសារ E159ដែលបានកំណត់ទៅដោយតុលាការហើយនៅក្នុងចំណុចទី8ដែលមានចំណុចឧបសម្ព័ន្ធ A4ដែលនៅក្នុងនោះគឺមានឯកសារ E9/31.3នៅក្នុងនោះ មានឯកសារពាក់ព័ន្ធគឺ E194/4.4ហើយឯកសារទាំងអស់គឺមាន394ឯកសារឯនោះអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំសូមកត់សម្គាល់នៅលើ2ចំណុចដែលអ្វីដែលបានលើកឡើងនោះគឺទី1គឺខ្ញុំសូមលើកអំពី បរិបត្តិទូទៅមួយដែលបង្ហាញអំពីថាតើសក្តានុពលនៃឯកសារដែលយើងបានប្រមូលមកនៅតុលាការនេះហើយមានយថាភាពមានភាពអាចជឿជាក់បានហើយមានភាពពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងយ៉ាងដូចម្តេចនោះខ្ញុំសូមលើកនៅ3ចំណុចទៀតគឺថាមានចំណុចកគឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹង តតិភាពនៃឯកសារចំណុចខគឺខ្ញុំចង់លើកអំពីថាតើឯកសារនឹងវាជាប្រភពមកពីណាហើយចំណុចខគឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងការគ្រប់គ្រងនៃឯកសារនេះចំណុចកដែលខ្ញុំចង់លើកថាតើតតិភាពនៃឯកសារបានន័យថាឯកសារដែលយើងបានមើលឃើញនៅពេលនេះវាមាន លក្ខណៈទម្រង់យ៉ាងម៉េចអញ្ចឹងដោយសហប្រញ្ញាបានលើកឡើងបាញ់មិញគឺថាមានទម្រង់ជាលក្ខណៈថាពីលើមកមានការបញ្ជាមានអីត្រឹមត្រូវហើយចំណុចមួយទៀតយើងពិនិត្យមើលថាតើឯកសារនឹងវាពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងចំណុចគោលដៅយ៉ាងដូចម្តេចគឺថាក្នុងឯកសារនឹងគឺមានចង្អុលបង្ហាញនៅគោលដៅនៃគំនិតនៅក្នុងនោះ ថាតើគំនិតនៃឯកសារហ្នឹងគេប្រើប្រាស់យ៉ាងដូចម្តេចចំណុចមួយទៀតដែលខ្ញុំចង់លើកឡើងដែរថាអ្វីដែលមានចំណុចដែលចែងនៅក្នុងជាទម្រង់ហើយជាគំនិតជាគោលដៅនៅក្នុងឯកសារទាំងនោះបានបង្ហាញនៅភាពដែលហៅថាវិភាពជឿទុកចិត្តបានបានអាចប្រើប្រាស់បានហើយចំណុចខគឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងប្រភព យើងពិនិត្យមើលលើឯកសារទាំងអស់នោះគឺថាប្រភពនៅយុថាចេញមកពីនៅក្នុងរបបកម្ពុជាយុគតៃតែម្ដងគឺថាក្នុងរយៈពេលឆ្នាំ 75 ដល់ 79 នេះឯង hay dương pin nứt mưa chấm nách mũi tiết thái tá nôn nè để chi bằng cá nâng bằng co nơi anh ra nỉ ban đây chi bẩn đá chi nẹt nghe chi nẹt đây bằng cá nơi anh ra nỉ đội hàng sạp đi nhà ban và chẳng mạnh mẽ khá bán miên xã xây mùi chúng luôn đây bằng chết ông pí ai cái sàn đi thả tá cốt bằng cao ai cái sàn dạng đôi mà đánh ấy con ông nước dương bị nứt nơi chấm lệnh mùi tiết thả tá ai cái sàn nó hai viên miên lẹ cái nạ dùng mạch viết chia rọ bài cá viết chia bằng chia viết chia vây on nó hái kế prapra đồng mạch prapra đồng bay đau cái đắp ông nái rọ bò cầm chia tay nhị ảnh rộp máu cứ tha bỏ pon lấy cả bẩn chun ai cả sa chia sa tu lấy cái đấy chia bẩn bẩn chia đấy chia rộp bài cả ấy cứ tha chia cả cột cón chia cả bằng hang ao khơi tha khung rộp bỏ nó cứ miên cả cột cón nâng rachana sầm pon ba lô sinh nhập cam chia tay ấy bẹ pon nâng chấm nách cổ khi ông xông lực lang tha vì miền ca bẩm mối nâng ca cục cồn ai cả xa hãy dưỡng ta mà quay đại trịa sau đây nơi con ông chân một con một cây sập pram ní cứ miền khang một chiếc đồ ai cả xa cứ đi xịt thêm như ai đã chỉ là tha ban môi đã quạt ban bẩm mai bẩm mối để ai cả xa để dưỡng ai cả xa khác dưỡng mình smart đó không hay chỉ chun cam chỉ dưỡng để ban ca làng máu có đã tận đạp tận đua họ bài hộp bán hay tận nực khơi như bẩm mai bẩm mối ai cả xa chẳng hay ai cả xa mua chầm luôn đấy, tầm khán nó việc bạn, ai bạn, chẳng bán kia mà chậm đồ nít cót bán, còn mai bỏ màu, mai màu xu ta cót ta cót sẽ tháp bán, cót thui cá và mai bỏ màu nít chia lẹ cả nãy giống mấy, bán được làng thà mình ai cứ riết rùm yên, tam bớt cót chia sẽ tháp bán mối, đào bấy xoay rốt nó cá bớt, cá nô, bạn, vấn đề đòi chạy đón cứ thà rì rò thà ba nâng tà la ông cao chết ban một cái tà la ca này lãng hình chứng viết chiếc bảo phúc nấy ai cả xa môi tuộc bay thà cả lãnh khá viên mình chứ bà lúa cả lãnh khá ai tà tùa dọc bàn cả đói cứ ta dương chiếc bảo phúc xin nháp vì cha ná mọ đó thẳng nhị ấy ai tà tùa bì sạ thà bàn bàn xa chết tà tùa bì tùa xa lãnh ai tà tùa bì bọc cư ập sinh này bậc cúl ban đây thay bậc cúl quạt chúng cá quạt chi sấm máy nút quạt chi nẹt đại phu nỉ xa nó tố hay quạt lưu thả miên ca của mô ảnh sát có quạt ban vô và chụp ảo được chưa nè pẹp pon chấm nợ ní nhung tròn và chẹt thả và sân bao dương sao triều rộ nẹt đại thả màu bậc cúl màu tật tu hay tăng pi sấm máy nút viên miên ca làm bạn mình tên hay miên ca biệt cột cồn hay năng riệp chạm tục cứ sinh nhập mọi đòi bên này để riệp chạm tục thì muối cứ bẹp pon ở bờ ra sát thì pí bẹp pon nâng cao vật tới đây là cả này ảnh khi em chôn tới chấm nói thì pí cứ ta top tới năng chấm nói chuyện này đây hàng metavica pía bàn được làng chấm nói muối nút khi em xong lượng thả lúc bàn dùng từ nâng tà la ca ICTY đã nâng tà la ca ICTY nâng bàn còn trường chỉ nẹ đã thư xa thủ lệ thư dạy nâng cứ thá màu bằng chắc nơi tà la ca bàn dường ní có ai còn trường một bàn đây phần tay ở vây đây chia ca sau xa đáy nâng cứ thá dạp bì nâng mọt đòi bì ní nây tà la ca dương vì miên chà chịa xa đáy cứ xám sắp cho nam chiếc áo khá cứ bạn slap bắt nó không sớm ấy pulpot hay khác dạ pel sam nam mó chặt bạn slap hỏi anh chấm chia nét đại miên sầm nắng cứ đôi khang sạm bị nhà bạn được làm bài mấy cho đàm miên đại miên sầm nắng môi chấm nón nắng cứ nắng mó bằng hai nơi nóng on tà la cà này anh chấm ở vây đại ca dương từ tà la cà ICTY nút cứ thà miên chấm nói lọ hai phần tay ở vây đại parabon nó cao một chía cứ được khi bàn được làm bánh mến chúng ta tí mối ai thế dạ piêu du bích quạt chá slap tí pí cứ quạt chá quạt mình ai phải đo sự kỳ cả mà nè anh nói chia chấm nó sầm khán sự nghiệp là cá bây giờ này
ចំណុចពាក់ព័ន្ធមួយទៀតថាចម្លើយសារភាពដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធការធ្វើទរណកម្មម្សិលមិញគឺខាងសហប្រញ្ញាក៏បានលើកឡើងហើយតែអ្វីដែលខ្ញុំសូមបន្ថែមនោះគឺថាប្រធានបទនេះគឺយើងនឹងមានការជជែកគ្នានៅប្រធានបទក្រោយចំណុចគោ ដែលលើកឡើងពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងដើមដឹងរាល់វិនីដែលថាបួនពាន់អ្នកនោះគឺថាតាមការពិតគឺមានចំនួនប្រកាសគឺ3,686នាក់បាទនេះគឺអ្វីដែលដើមដឹងរាល់វិនីពិតប្រកាសហើយខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់ថាដើមដឹងរាល់វិនីដែលនឹងឡើងដែលបានដាក់ស្នើសុំឲ្យតុលាការ ស្ដាប់នៅសក្កិកម្មនោះគឺប្រហែលជា150នាក់បាទហើយនៅក្នុងចំណោម150នាក់នេះក៏ដើមដឹងមួយចំនួនតូចទេដែលនឹងបង្ហាញខ្លួននៅក្នុងសវនាការវគ្គដំបូងនេះដូច្នេះខាងមេធាវីការពារក៏មានការបារម្ភច្រើនពេកព្រោះថាមានតិចតួចសញ្ញាពិចារណាចំពោះពួកគាត់ ចំណុចមួយទៀតដែលខ្ញុំចង់បញ្ជាក់នោះថាពួកគាត់ដែលឡើងមកថ្លែងសេចក្តីកម្មគឺក្នុងនាមជាដើមដឹងរបបនេះដែលមតិមួយចំនួនបានយល់ច្រឡំនោះថាគាត់ឡើងមកក្នុងនាមជាសាក្សីវិញអញ្ចឹងមិនមែនទេគឺឡើងមកជាដើមដឹងរបបនេះ ចំណុចសំខាន់មួយទៀតដែលខាងមេធាវីការពារបានលើកឡើងថាឈ្មោះកូនក្តីរបស់លោកគេដាក់ចំឡងជូនថាតើគាត់បានទទួលឬទេនេះចំណុចនេះដែលខ្ញុំចង់បញ្ជាក់នោះថាបើយើងពិនិត្យទៅបទឋានសម័យនោះបទឋានសម័យនោះថាគេប្រើអីគេប្រើនិរសាហើយសួរថានិរសា នេះសាគាត់ជាអ្នកបញ្ជូនសម្បត្តិបញ្ជូនសាពីបុគ្គលឬពួយពីស្ថាប័នទៅបុគ្គលនៃស្ថាប័នមួយទៀតអញ្ចឹងនេះសានេះគឺមានលក្ខណៈសំខាន់ហើយជាបុគ្គលដែលគេទុកចិត្តណាដោយហេតុថាអ្នកដែលនេះសានឹងគឺមានការស្មោះត្រង់ចំពោះអ្វីដែលជាអង្គភាពរបស់គេធ្វើការបុគ្គលនិងភារកិច្ចនេះហើយនេះសាជំនាន់នោះគឺ បើនៅតាមជនបទគឺភាគច្រើនគាត់ជិះសេះទៀតបាទអញ្ចឹងជាការបញ្ជូនសម្បត្តិហើយអ្វីដែលយើងចង់បញ្ជាក់ថាទទួលឬមិនបានទទួលប៉ះសិនបើនីរសានឹងបញ្ជូនសម្បត្តិទៅមិនបានទទួលអ្នកនោះប្រហែលជាមិនអាចជានីរសាបានយូរទេបាទដូច្នេះចំណុចនេះខ្ញុំចង់បញ្ជាក់ថាការដែលដាក់ឈ្មោះថាចំឡងជូន គឺមានការប្រកាសណាស់ថាគាត់នឹងបានទទួលនៅព័ត៌មាននេះចំណុចដែលចុងក្រោយដែលខ្ញុំចង់ធ្វើការកត់សម្គាល់ទៅលើឯកសារនោះដែរគឺចំណុចទី1គឺមានឯកសារលេខ D 366/7.1. 338 ខ្ញុំចង់បញ្ជាក់ថាឡើងវិញគឺអ្វីដែលយើងបានពិនិត្យទៅលើឯកសារនេះគឺថាឃើញពីលក្ខណៈទម្រង់មានលំដាប់លំដោយត្រឹមត្រូវមានការរសេរត្រឹមត្រូវណាមានខ្លឹមសារត្រឹមត្រូវមានការចោះការបរិច្ឆេទទៀតអញ្ចឹងបានន័យថាវាជា លក្ខណៈមួយបានន័យថាចង់បញ្ជាក់ថាខាងមេធាវីការពារបានលើកឡើងថាអ្នកដែលធ្វើនឹងគាត់មានចំណាញត្រឹមណាមានកម្រិតវប្បធម៌ត្រឹមណាមានស្អីត្រឹមណាអញ្ចឹងបើយើងពិនិត្យទៅអ្វីដែលជាតត្យភាពជាក់ស្ដែងនៃឯកសារនេះគឺថាមើលទៅគាត់ថាអ្នកនឹងបើមិនចេះមិនចំណាញមិនដឹងអីសោះក៏មិនអាចធ្វើឯកសារនេះបានដែរ ហើយប្រើពាក្យពេចន៍ដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងកម្ពុជាជាប្រទេសទាំងអស់ bạn hãy có đôi chia anh xa xa tu lệch mùi đại miền lệch đi mà rồi bằng bấy xa lắc mà phây bằng bấy chọn mùi đại bạn ở khăn ông nút cứ đã thì và toàn tìm mùi kháng chú ý những cái đã lệch xa xa mùi hay khổ ông lệch xa xa mùi đã pi rối ha sập pi rối hốc sập pram tùng nè ấy cái đã là rộp chún mô bầm bay rối chật chỉ tí xe này ha nâng nâng rồi lực nè sật tập phía xá nông xa mày nông đôi chân này kháng kram ní miên chùm lòng chún ông nuốn bóng ván bóng vón bóng khiếu muốn tí nâng ai kia xa nhưng chân ní cứ chìa bài bọt môi xì nhạp xa mày nông kì pra pra ấy bà con ná thá nẹ thằng ó nông nâng tự tụ bàn hay có đôi chị ai cái xa môi tiết đại miền lề đi mà rồi bằng bấy mà phây bằng muối ớt sạc mà phây bằng muối phải bằng muối đây đại khang miền vika pia bàn lực làng đấy cứ tha mờ từ bài mình chấp ba anh ấy cứ tha ca vay tật lô cho non nú hay miền ca bị bọt chán mà tiết cứ tha miền sạc nam đại miền lệch nào mình chấp ba mình thấy thằng lứa dương mưa cho ba cứ tha từ mình tí so mà phải mùi nồng bình cái nhất cho ba mình tên bọn chỉ tì cơ rộp mình chấn sợ tại chỉ phía xa đại sầm mày nút bàn thừa ấy bữa thứ ngày khai với cứ lát thằng nã si sùng vạc nè thằng lứa cứ tha ngày sam sầm mùi ôi sập phía cho năm một con chật sập vào mũi hay đó là thằng cống ngày đại bàn cơ rộp chun để thui ai giá nó cứ tha ngày mùi mì thừa ná một con một đôi chật sập bờ chấn ban này đã việt si cái này ban này đã lủng đập nói này ai xa ban trầm trệ đôi chân này khi mà sông mình chạy chun chia rừng chạy sát đánh nơi bẹp con ai xa ní hay khi mà sông group ông chùm ré hay sông mita vichana nơi lơ ai xa đại dương và mùa bán hay dương năng bị trả ná từ lư chấm nốt đại bẹp pon đại khi ông bàn được làng ní vì chia phết đại a chưa tục bán chưa tục chặt bán hay phết đại miến cà bẹp pon hay chấm nốt anh ní dương a dọn mò chia ai xa phò tang nơi khấn ông tất cả ní bà sông mò quân
bà ông quân lục mệnh tử vi hay chia cái bản to គឺយើងធ្វើសកម្មភាពលើការជំទាស់ទៅនឹងឯកសារសម័យកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យដែលអង្គជំរះត្រូវដំបូងដែលមានបំណងដាក់ចំពោះមុខខ្លួនគឺបន្តការស្ដាប់ជំទាស់ពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងឯកសារក្នុងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធអេ5ក្រមមេធាវីការពារក្តីនីមួយៗមានរយៈពេល40នាទីនៅក្នុងការបង្ហាញពីការជំទាស់របស់ខ្លួនលើកលែងតែក្រមមេធាវីការពារក្តីទាំង3ក្រមមានការបែងចែកពេលវេលាដែលផ្ដល់ឲ្យ ខូពីនេះហើយជាដំបូងនេះអង្គជំរះសូមបង្គោលវេទិកាទៅមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកនួនជាដើម្បីមានឱកាសនៅក្នុងការបង្ហាញអំពីការជំទាស់របស់ខ្លួនពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងឯកសារក្នុងអបអសម្ព័ន្ធអេ5សូមអញ្ជើញ
Thank you, Your Honour. I'll keep it brief in order to avoid unnecessary repetition. The SICEM documents, we've discussed those at length. We welcome the announcement the prosecution made this morning that they will provide everyone with a list of documents received from the SICEM, and we're looking forward to studying that. Of course, the admission of those documents, as we have said many times this week, is subject to the hearing of Yuk Cheng in court, and us, the defence, giving the opportunity to cross-examine him. As far as the relevance is concerned, the prosecutor made some remarks on the relevance of certain documents, and we agree the scope of the first immediate trial is not limited to the evacuation of Phnom Penh or the first movement of people from north or from south to north. The topic of the first trial is also the hierarchy of the party, the command structure, communications within the DK. We take the position, however, and we disagree with the prosecutor that when your trial chamber will look at those topics, at those additional issues relevant for the structure of the country, the party, the government, that emphasis should lie on the relevant period, the period relevant for the evacuation of Phnom Penh and the phase 2 movement of population. Just to give you one example, the prosecution was giving examples this morning. Weda Yeng Thirit was informed in July 1978, which is 2 years after the relevant period, whether she was informed on the political consciousness of midwives in a particular hospital we maintain is completely irrelevant for the first mini-trial. It doesn't say anything of any relevance to the first mini-trial. Even if it says something about the structure of that particular ministry in 1978, it only confuses the things that we have to discuss in the first mini-trial. So we maintain that the emphasis should lie when we discuss the structure of the party and the government, the emphasis should lie on the first period relevant for the evacuation of Phnom Penh and the subsequent movement of people from south to north. What we are afraid of, that is going to happen is that the prosecutor will take this opportunity to introduce evidence into this first mini-trial in order to extend the scope of this first mini-trial. I think a very good example was given this morning by the OCP when they showed us several documents related to S21 and the alleged purge of a person who worked in Hong Kong for an office established by DK for trade purposes. Whether this office was purged, whether cadres from this office were sent to S21, S21 was established, as you know, after the evacuation of Phnom Penh, and whether any of the accused knew about this is absolutely, we maintain, is completely irrelevant for this first mini-trial. It is not on your agenda. We will discuss this later to a great extent without any doubt. I again invite the trial chamber to look at the list of documents provided by the prosecutor with a very critical eye and to discard as irrelevant all evidence which really has nothing to do with the scope of the first mini-trial. With regard to the other documents which are prima facie relevant for the first mini-trial and documents which have not been provided by DC Chem, we repeat our position, as explained earlier this week, that evidence is admissible, but if those documents contain evidence on the role of our client or evidence on key issues in the first mini-trial, then we maintain that those documents should be put before our client, is testifying, and that if necessary, the author of that particular document should be heard in court. Thank you very much.
សូមគោរពអង្គសារការសូមគោរពលោកប្រធាននៅក្នុងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធ 5លេខ 9 flash 611.4 មាននិយាយតែអំពីរបាយការណ៍ពីម្នាក់ទៅម្នាក់ពីថ្នាក់ក្រោមទៅថ្នាក់លើពីកងឯកភាពឬមន្ទីរ 1ទៅមន្ទីរ 1ទៀត ละអំពីទួលលេខពីម្នាក់ទៅម្នាក់ពីកងឯកភាព1ទៅកងឯកភាព1ទៀតពីភូមិ1ភូមិភាគ1ទៅភូមិភាគ1ទៀតសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍របស់ក្រុងដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយព្រះអង្គម្ចាស់នរោត្តមសេនុស្តីអំពីសមាជិកភាពរដ្ឋាភិបាលក្រុងនៅថ្ងៃទី 5 ខែតុលាឆ្នាំ 1974 មានការបោះពុម្ពផ្សាយ របស់ហ្វុងមានចំណងជើងថាព័ត៌មានកម្ពុជាមានឯកសារលេខ D36 flash 7.1.4 ពីថ្ងៃ 3 ខែសុភាឆ្នាំ 1970 ដែលមានលេខរៀងរហូត ដល់ IS18.1 ដល់ IS12.3 នៅថ្ងៃទី 28 សីហាឆ្នាំ 1975 មានរបាយការណ៍សារព័ត៌មានកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យ លេខ D262.13 ចុះថ្ងៃទី 3 ធ្នូ 1975 និងរបាយការណ៍មួយចំនួនទៀត ព្រមទាំងសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍របស់រដ្ឋាភិបាលកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យមួយចំនួនទៀតដែរ បូកទាំងរបាយការណ៍សារព័ត៌មានកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យ ច្រើនលេខនិយាយអំពីការលុកលុយរបស់កងទ័ពវៀតណាមធ្វើដោយឈ្មោះតាន់វ៉ាន់តៃជាយោធាវៀតណាមដែលកម្ពុជាទីបតៃចាប់បានពេលដែលវៀតណាមវាយចូលលុកលុយដល់ប្រទេសកម្ពុជាបានសារភាពប្រាប់កងទ័ពបដិវត្តកម្ពុជាថ្ងៃ 24 មករា 1978 ឯកសារលេខ IS 12.26 ចំពោះរបាយការណ៍សារទូតលេខសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍របស់ហ្វុងរបស់ក្រុងដែលធ្វើដោយព្រះអង្គម្ចាស់នរោត្តមសីហនុថ្លែងការណ៍របស់រដ្ឋាភិបាលកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យនិងរបាយការណ៍សារព័ត៌មានរបស់កម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យផងនោះគឺសុទ្ធសឹងតែនិយាយអំពីការងារប្រចាំថ្ងៃរបស់ខ្លួនបើសិនជាឯកសារទាំងអស់នោះ ជាឯកសារពិតមានយថាភាពមុតច្បាស់ហើយដែលថតចំណងចេញពីសំណៅដើមរបស់វាដែលឆមជ្ឈមណ្ឌលឯកសារកម្ពុជាឬពីប្រភពច្បាស់ការណាប្រកាសជាមានមែននោះកូនក្តីរបស់ខ្ញុំនួនជានឹងធ្វើការឆ្លើយតបតទល់នឹងសហប្រជាជាតិយ៉ាងមុតច្បាស់យ៉ាងក្លាហាន ពុំមានការទើសតល់ដោយសពថ្ងៃដែលបានចំទាស់នឹងសុំឲ្យតុលាការបង្ហាញបញ្ជាឲ្យសហប្រជាបង្ហាញនៅច្បាប់ដើមមកដើម្បីលោកនួនជាធ្វើការគូផ្គងឲ្យបានមុតច្បាស់ហើយបើឯកសារនោះលោកនួនជាទទួលស្គាល់ថាជារបស់កម្ពុជាជាប្រតីធ្វើឡើង កាលសម័យកាន់អំណាចមែននោះលោកនួនជាពុំរីរែកនៅការចោតប្រកាន់មកលើរូបលោកនោះទេហេតុនេះបានជានួនជាព្រមទាំងសហមេធាវីរបស់លោកព្រមទាំងមេធាវីការពារជនជាប់ចោតទាំងអស់មានយោបល់ប្រហាក់ប្រហែលគ្នាទាមទារយកឯកសារសំណៅដើមមកបង្ហាញដែលអ្វីសហប្រាជ្ញា បានចោតប្រកាន់ហើយខំដើរប្រមូលយកទាំងអ្វីដែលមិនត្រូវចោតប្រកាន់មកដាក់ទម្ងន់ទោសមកលើជនជាប់ចោតនោះ mình men xâm hạt xâm phá để mình bỏ cọp đó dễ thả phiếp tốt tế xa. Khiêm dân kết khơi thả chạp vì ngày tì đập rộng mùi khai mẹ gà ra chạm bì bọn đọc bí tù là ca bàn chạp đám dọc bành chi ổ bạc xâm phá bì mùi đọc tì bám một chạy khí nha đám bay xoay rộng cả bất hãy bắt đầu nâu dù tì thô nâng dọc chìa ca dọc chìa ca bàn nô khiêm xôm bạc xe ca cho bà căn đại khám yên phó tăng chạy lẹ dọc xóm nào ai kia xa đại mình miên dịa tháp hiếp một xóm an đám bay cho bà căn khôn cơ đại khiêm ổ tì hò đô chìa ai kia xa đại bàn xa nào xôm đại khiêm bà bàn xa nào xôm tù là ca ảnh nhạt bằng chăng slide chun tù là ca nâng xa thiên nạ chun mơ ca lpi mà xa mình tha chìa ai kia xa mình bật bà cọt mình miên phiếp chìa ca chùm lòng miên phiếp chìa ca chùm lòng xót xát vì xâm nào đám nụ tì xâm tù mình miên phiếp chìa ca chùm lòng xót xát vì xâm nào đám nụ tì mà dàng mình tiết giả hạ bởi nhà nông rịa bìa buồn thằng ngày ní có bùm ban bằng hai nâu sẽ khai cầm cho bà lo thả khôn ban ai kia xa tiếng bòn tùm bòn ní mọc bì nà bì cần lành ná ban mọc đòi rồi bìm nà ở chân trâu chọt dù cho bà môn nâng chọt bà cánh hai tụt tùl dọc bàn ai kia xa tiếng bòn tùm bò đại bà rịa nhà ban tụt tùl sọ đòi khôn ánh hai bà tra cho lê đòi khôn ánh nô xâm rạp tẹt đặn bằng túc tô mọc lư côn cây bọc hiếm nôn chía nâng chân trâu chọt ai tiết bà nô tì bông miên thăng thành rộng ca bất rộng dù đi thó nâng ao miên bà giáo đó sẵn cung nâng xa thiên nạ tốt tại sao được chứ này không niêm khiêm được chứ này khiêm không niêm chân trời cháu khiêm xong tà là cả bị chá ra nà nâng tràn cháu nô bị cháu bà căn mình xong hạt phá đài bông miên dễ tháp hiếp không ca cháu bà căn xa nô chấm phô chấm hô bà mê vi ca biên nôn chí nếu ta tự tu xâm ôi bà rịa nhà bằng hai nâu ai kia xa đám đó đây là đám bay ôi miên dạy tháp hiếp nâng dự thị thoa khăn ông tà la ca ôi bà tù còn đi xôm một chiếc phong đai thà ai kia xa đây bà rịa nhà miên sân tay tăng ốc bông miên nẹ tự tu khó trâu cứ khuyên miên hạt thạ lì khá xa nam mê đáy nâng chốt ngay khai chân nắm chân nắm cho hạt thạ lì khá tôi thấy sao ai xa tiếng ơn đi vô vô bình tu tiếng bật tế đòi bộ miên dịa tháp hiếp nâng bật cót bật chìa tôi thấy sao ta bật riêng ta bật riêng ở nhà ai dô bàn tế thả ai xa tiếng ơn đi miên nẹ đọt tế miên krom chìa bà cha mất rồi bọc cam bật chìa bật chìa thập tay ai thư ở vây rồi bằng cách đòi chạy tên là đảm bây chìa phá bà giáo cho rồi bỏ kì rồi bỏ cổng kì nước bàn đại rửa tì ní bà rìa nhà bì nứt bì cháy ở bàn mặt chót nếu ai xa tiếng nục chăm phố mê thê vi đàm bà đăng rạch bà bà ní một đọc rài nếu thằng ấy ní chăm phố ốc bà xâm phân buôn bạn thả nét đại lạc là một thư sắc khai cam chung phục tòa là cả nốt mình nét sạp nét khá chắc cho riêng mình ai một bàn hai nét ai một bàn có bàn một thư sắc khai cam rồi hai đại toàn chung lạc ni mình chỉ cả bất tư khiêm dư sạp thả khiêm dư sạp thả mình nét ai một thư sắc khai chia xa xây miền nạc lạc chá slap nô chia cà bật ta nạc đài ai mọc thư chia xa khai cam nô bán nô miền chá nạ à dụ con nô thư cà bán xoài thư cà bán xoài bán rương đài dương bán cho chạy khen nô bê nì công mê thư vi nôn chia bán thư lì khách sna xâm tam rịa chá krom sơ bóng kết ơ chùm nôn chiêng bốn xa nam cà lòng tù hai តែសហជក្រមស៊ើបអង្កេតបានធ្វើការកោះហៅតែសាក់សីនោះបដិសេធមិនមកនេះជាសមត្ថកិច្ចរបស់តុលាការចំពោះសាក់សីមានផលប្រយោជន៍ទាំងនោះហេតុដូចខ្ញុំបានជម្រាបតុលាការពីនេះខ្ញុំសូមតុលាការច្រានចោលនៅការចោទប្រកាន់នៅអបអសម្ព័ន្ធ 5នេះចោលមេធាវីនួនជានៅតែរក្សា នៅការទទួលសុំឲ្យប្រាជ្ញាផ្ដល់នៅឯកសារដើមមានយថាភាពប្រកាសប្រជាមានតម្លៃមកបង្ហាញចំពោះតុលាការនិងចំពោះសាធារណជនដើម្បីឲ្យលោកនួនជាអាចតបតដោយសន្តិចិត្តទៅប្រាជ្ញាវិញសូមអរគុណលោក
អរគុណលោកមេធាវី
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honors, and good morning to everyone in and around the courtroom. I believe we have already noted our objections as to these types of evidence in our general remarks. As we noted that media reports are in and of themselves unreliable unless some sort of indicia of reliability can be shown, especially when statements are attributed to our client or to the other accused. And then those purported statements or paraphrasing what our clients may have said is taken at face value. We noted, for instance, one example in the past with respect to Elizabeth Becker, which dealt with the 1975 Mayaguez incident. We then noted or informed that we should simply look at Elizabeth Becker's notes that are in the case file, and therein would lie the answers. Well, if you were to go to the case file and look at her notes, you would not find anything with respect to that particular piece of evidence that is being sought to be introduced. Now, that said, we understand that the prosecution intends to introduce these sorts of types of evidence for various reasons. And of course, it would be up to you, Your Honors, to determine whether those that piece of evidence can come in limited to the purpose for which the prosecution intends to use that information. Of course, it would be up to the prosecution to inform the parties exactly the purpose. We submit, Your Honors, and this is something that I will touch upon later this afternoon when we do our wrap-up remarks concerning our responses to all of these specific types of evidence, is that simply because something is in the case file or simply because something is referenced in the closing order doesn't make it necessarily admissible for trial. If that were the case, then why are we bothering with this entire exercise? The entire case file can simply be used by any party. And so simply to say, well, it's referenced in this paragraph, therein lies the answer. Our position is, be that as it may, at some point, since the prosecution bears the burden of proof, they will have to demonstrate why this particular document is, aside from being relevant, but why it should be relied upon by this trial chamber, and why at some point it should have any weight to this particular phase of the indictment that we're trying, that is trial number one, limited to that. And so we respectfully submit that we have provided our answers in our annex. They're general in nature, but over the course of the last two or three days, we've amply noted why we believe that The prosecution cannot simply say, well, it's in the closing order, therefore it should be admitted. There's nothing in international standards that says if something is in the indictment or if something is referenced in the indictment, and because the indictment was based on something that was shown to the judges as part of the process of determining whether sufficient evidence exists to indict, that in and of itself does not make that piece of evidence admissible. It merely means that it was used by the trial chamber or the presiding judge who was involved in the indictment process in factoring that as part of the test as to whether some evidence is sufficient to indict. That's all. And therefore, for the prosecution to say, well, it's in the closing order, and therefore it has credence, we submit that's not enough. That's the first step. Now that we've started the trial, they will have to lay more of a foundation, and it's up to you to determine whether it should be admitted, and then whether it should, how much weight, if any, to give to it. Thank you.
លោកមេធាវីជាកិច្ចបន្តអញ្ញាប្រកុលវិធីការទៅមេធាវីការពីក្តីលោកខៀវសំផនដើម្បីមានឱកាសក្នុងការឡើងធ្វើឯកសារនិងឡើងធ្វើការបង្ហាញអំពីការជំទាស់របស់ខ្លួនទៅលើឯកសារដែលមាននៅក្នុងឧបត្តិសម្ព័ន្ធ
A5សូមជឿនសមអគុណលោកប្រធានសូមគ្រប់ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាជំនុំជម្រះអង្គសវនាការទាំងមូលក្នុងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធទី5នេះស្ដីអំពីសារព័ត៌មានកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យនិងសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍ជាសាធារណៈដែលសហប្រញ្ញាបានលើកចំនួន 343 ឯកសារក្នុងឯកសារ E158 ដែលសហប្រញ្ញាបានលើកមកនេះគឺថាសហប្រញ្ញាបានព្យាយាមផ្ដល់តម្រុយទៅលើភាពជឿជាក់ទៅលើចំពោះឯកសារនោះចំនួន 60 ក្នុងចំណោមឯកសារទាំងអស់ដែលមាន 343 នៅក្នុងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធនេះឯកសារចំនួន 53 នៃឯកសារទាំងនោះបានមកពី ប្រភពដែលហៅថាការប្រមូលចងក្រងឯកសារដោយប្រទេសស៊ុយអែត Swedish Collection ឬសេវាផ្សព្វផ្សាយព័ត៌មានអន្តរជាតិ FBIS ក្រៅពីនោះមានឯកសារ 5 ដែលជា សារព័ត៌មានទទួលបានពីមជ្ឈមណ្ឌលឯកសារកម្ពុជា DC Camp អ្វីដែលជាការទៀមទាក៏ដូចជាការជំទាស់របស់យើងខ្ញុំចំពោះការផ្ដល់ឯកសារនានាពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធនេះមិនខុសពីអ្វីដែលយើងបាន លើកក្នុងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធមុនទេដូច្នេះខ្ញុំបាននឹងមិនបង្ហាញភាពលម្អិតនៃការចំទាស់របស់យើងខ្ញុំទៀតទេយើងខ្ញុំសូមរក្សានៅគោលជំហរនៃការចំទាស់នេះដូចមាននៅក្នុងឧបសម្ព័ន្ធមុនដែរឧទាហរណ៍ថា ឯកសារដែលទទួលបានពីប្រទេសស៊ុយអែតយើងឃើញថាឯកសារទាំងនេះទើបតែទទួលបានក្នុងពេលថ្មីៗហើយដែលចងល់ដែលយើងទាំងអស់គ្នាឆ្ងល់នោះថាតើប្រទេសស៊ុយអែតនេះ ban tu tu ai sa tiang nu doi ro biep na neu pel na pi no na ni chi chom naot da jeung tiang ok khnia chang dang hai dal saha pri anya trai tae bong hanh om pi phiep chue chiak tiang os nu om te leu ai ka sa ni muoy ni muoy dam bai jeung ai dược mau bị phía xa đỉnh đào lầm ớt từ lưỡi ai cả xa đi mùi nu to từ tiền đối chứ nè sắp xây máu khiêm bát xông rẽ xa chầm hô rồi bỏ dược khiêm đọt đài xông ớt cun
bà ớt cun tôi mình thử ví đời em lòng bây giờ bên này cả chơi ăn ăn to rồi bỏ ปริญญาមានរហូតដល់មានម៉ោងឯណោះហើយឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសំលមមនិងសម្រាប់ឲ្យដែរបណ្ឌិតថាយើងក៏បីសម្រាប់មុនពេលផ្ដល់វិធីការទៅសហពញ្ញាដើម្បីធ្វើអំណះអំណាមតបដូច្នេះអង្គជំរះប្រកាសសម្រាប់20នាទីចាប់ពេលនេះទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង11:30នាទីសូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសំណាកា